From the African Sportsman team to you guys here at the Hello Africa Safaris, Chris and Jurgens, thank you so much. This week was an unforgettable one. We spent some time here in Natal on your home base here between Wasbank and Dundee. Chris, just take our viewers quickly through it. What happened this week?
Yeah, we've taken you guys to the free range area, and yeah, we lucked out and you shot a nice kudu bull, well done.
I think a nice kudu bull is a bit of an understatement, but Jurgens, I mean, we spoke about it the whole week. There's no way you can plan a kudu hunt. There's no way you can script it. I mean, I've been looking for a decent size kudu bull. I've hunted splendid bulls before, old bulls. But never got to that magical mark of I don't know what the magical mark is, you know, well over 50. Is it the Roland Ward mark? Is it the whatever? But I mean, irrespective of the size of the kudu we hunted this week, what a splendid bull! I mean, you captured it well yesterday as well.
Yeah, no, it's Stefan, it's like I told you as well. When we went out, we knew what we were looking for. It's an old kudu bull, and whatever the inches was a bonus. So. And we ended up with an exceptional kudu bull yesterday.
Yeah, I wanna take this a few steps back. The reason why you guys invited us is we're sitting here in the first week of the new year. It's summer. It's early morning. It's already almost 30 degrees Celsius. Yeah, it's nice and hot. The flies are everywhere. It is normally and traditionally an uncomfortable time of the year to hunt. Jurgens, explain to us why you guys did invite us this time of the year. You explained it to us when you invited us. It sounded a bit strange, but I mean, here we are and we experienced it. And it, I mean, what a week it was. Eh?
Yeah, Stefan, it's like everyone thinks you just hunt in the winter times. But yeah, like we spoke about as well, this time of the year when it's real hot and nice and green, the big kudu bulls form bachelor groups out and they come out into the open to get away from the insects and so on. And they're after that yellow flowers of the sweet acacia. And so. But like you saw yesterday, how the flies covered that kudu, and yeah, they would be standing still and suddenly just take off running for 20 yards and then stop. And that's just to get away from all those insects. And so.
Yeah. And we saw a bunch of kudu yesterday, Chris. I mean, you guys explained, I want you to touch on it. What we hunted is what we call in South Africa cattle farms and you know, with low fences. So for something like a Steenbok or Orebi or a Warthog or Impala or Kudu. I mean, it's a total free range area. Those fences, you know, do not keep wild animals in. So, I mean, the magnitude of this area is just unbelievable. Eh?
Yeah, we got access to 100,000 hectares, yeah, at least.
Yeah. And that's almost 500,000 acres. Eh?
Yeah, and it's like you said, it's cattle farms and maize, some of them maize farms. And yeah, it's Impala, free range Impala, free range Nyala, common reedback, mountain reedback,
bushbuck,
and a lot of warthog, bushpig,
yeah, and then obviously the kudu.
And then obviously the kudu is this area is kudu area,
and yeah, that's what it's known for. And yeah, this yeah area is known for.
There's a couple of areas in South Africa where you can hunt a big kudu bull, and this part of Natal is definitely one of them.
Oh yeah, sure.
Before I touch on this wonderful facility here behind us, I want to quickly touch on the hunt we did. It was a proper spot and stalk hunt. That's how you guys explained it. We drove up to one of the highest mountains you have in this area. And then we set off on foot for a couple of hundred yards, armed with our binos and shooting sticks and whatever. And then we started to glass. And I mean, from there, we could see, we spotted kudu, I would say, up to 2 kilometers away.
2 kilometers away, yeah, yeah. And you yeah could just see its bulls. You couldn't even see what size the bulls was.
Yeah, yeah. So that's the method you guys use here. And then from there on, Jurgens, I mean, obviously you guys know the area. You know where the open areas are. And obviously with your guys' experience in this area for, Chris, more than 20, 30 years hunting here, you know exactly where those open patches are. And, you know, determining the wind direction, checking where the movement is, we set off. And I mean, it was almost like you scripted it, Jurgens. And it was, you know, it really works out that way, you know, because, I mean, hunting is always hunting. But we set over that first mountain, and on the second valley, where you explained there's a highly, you know, it's highly likely we will find the kudu there. That's where we found them.
We couldn't ask for it to happen any better. Eh? Yeah. It was just
And we saw in, I don't know, in 2 hours we saw close to 100 kudu.
Yeah, like bulls and cows. At least. And the nice thing is there's areas we haven't hunted before. So you go to an area you know, don't know what you're gonna get.
Yeah.
I mean there's some bulls never been seen.
And where we stood, we looked in a direction, I mean this wide. The hunting area was all around us. You know? Yeah. So we chose the area where we saw the most activity. And then obviously the hunt itself, I mean it was sitting in the shade, I said it to the camera yesterday, sitting on a rock with my shooting sticks with a gun rest at the front and at the back. I mean couldn't ask for a more stable shooting position. It was a bit further than we anticipated. But yeah, the shot went well and actually the kudu moved a little bit, but luckily we used a sufficient caliber and bullet combination and I mean it anchored the kudu just there. And Jurgens, you told me, so you know normally with a good lung shot, you know, it takes a couple of seconds, but you just told me please get in a second shot. And when we reached the kudu, that kudu managed, I don't know, 40 yards 50 yards, and when we reached the kudu where it was down, I mean 10 paces further, it was a drop, I don't know, 80-100 yard drop, almost 90 degrees down. We took a beautiful picture there.
And, so and the rest of the kudus went all down there, so yeah, luckily they didn't follow them.
I mean, if that bull went over
we would have had a long day.
And then obviously the recovery, because we were on top of this mountain. Chris, you were still scouting the other side looking for kudu, because, I mean, we were just walking and hoping to get something. After the guys scammed you a little bit and said, yeah, we shot a decent 48, 49 inch bull. And you had to.
Yeah, it was a long road. Yes, a long road for recovery.
I just can imagine, you know, every hit with that machete, you're thinking, oh, just let this be the one. But I mean, you guys struggled up there for almost an hour building a road.
That's almost 2 hours, yeah. We came down the mountain and
yeah, well, first you had to come down one mountain. And then up the one we were.
Up the mountain, clearing the rocks and clearing the branches. that was hard work.
That's obviously the one part of it. You know, it's hard work recovering that kudu. And in the time like this, you'll see on the footage and on the photos, we covered that you know the kudu, the cape, we covered with branches to try and get it out of the sun as much as possible. But that's the one thing you guys really need to. You know, you have to be able to make a plan in getting to a certain area where hunt the kudu, because there's no plan, there's no script, there's no roads.
Yeah, but you're lucky, Stefan. Actually, I mean, sometimes you can't get to the kudu.
Yeah.
And you need to dress it out in a mountain, carry the cape out, carry the meat out. At least you could have got there with the vehicle yesterday. That made it much easier. That was one of my worries driving down there.
Yeah, I think it's the experience of our PhD. I must be honest. Listen, guys, I just want to ask you, The lodge at the back. This is your home base. Am I right?
Yes.
We're in Natal between Wasbank and Dandia. This is where you're situated, but it's not only here where you hunt, eh?
No.
But let's just focus on this quickly. Please explain. Yeah. I mean, we've stayed here, you know, family and friends, and it was absolute. I mean, it's stunning accommodation. It's just like we've experienced. How many times through Africa? I must compliment you on that.
Thank you.
But just explain to the viewers, I mean, how many rooms and whatever you have here, and then obviously Jurgens about your other hunting concessions as well.
Yeah, this is a free chalets with two beds in each, and extra space for children. And this is a private lodge. I think that's the important thing. So if you book with your friends or family or whatever, you're the only one in this lodge. There's not other people in the lodge. So you're just a private lodge. You sit around the fire and enjoy your family or your friends.
Yeah. And then obviously with this wonderful dam here, the kids caught a couple of bass yesterday.
Couple of bass, so nice.
And the views, I mean, with all these
mountains. And then it was just nice at night, the animals come in to the water.
Yeah.
And drink water and the spotlight, so that's beautiful. The kudu bulls came in. I think you've seen some nice Nyala bulls fighting the one day.
Yeah.
And it worked out well, and we're blessed.
Jurgens, your other concessions where you guys hunt all through southern Africa, not only South Africa.
Yes, southern Africa, all over in South Africa. Then we hunt. If we go for more dangerous games, we move into Mozambique and those countries as well.
You have a stunning hunting area in Namibia as well?
Yes. Yeah. Yes, we hunt other areas in Namibia, and it all depends on the client what he wants to hunt. Yeah. We accommodate them and
according to
what they want. So
yeah, we tailor a package deal for him.
Guys, I wanna compliment you on the outfit you run. I wanna thank you for the invite, and I mean it was just an absolute mind-boggling couple of days here. I mean, to see this area, to see the amount of kudu, and then obviously accomplishing what we want. I mean, luck has got a big part to play, but for your guys' preparation and the willingness to be able to set this up, I want to thank you. To all the Hello Africa returning clients, I mean, I'm sure you can't wait to get back here, and obviously to all the new potential clients. If you want to shoot a big kudu bull, I think you know where to go.